mentioned pace earlier on in your statement there, and I want to dive into that a little bit more, because I think that a lot of people would make the assumption, myself included, that the pace is largely determined in the edit. How are you creating a pace in your cinematography? How are you creating this Scandinavian pace? And actually, maybe the first thing is to let us know what are the elements that make something a little bit more Scandic in their cinematic pace.
It's a tempo thing, and it's about the length of shots. It's about the camera movement and the speed at which the camera moves. It's the pace of cutting, which you're absolutely right about. You can take something that's a very kind of calculated tempo, and you can speed it up by quick cuts, but that's not in this. You know, we wanted to let shots linger. We wanted you to have opportunities to experience what the characters are experiencing. And we created shots that lasted longer, that took us from one scene to the next. And we tried to simplify when possible so that it was not a lot of cutting back and forth, but more a study of the humanity within the shots. Mm.
Did you make the choice to have less coverage, or did you do regular coverage and then just the changes were in the edit?
Well, we were pragmatic about it, and we did as much coverage as we thought was necessary, and we didn't cut corners, and we allowed the most choices later. But the notion was to stay in them longer and utilize them as long as possible.
Yeah, I can imagine that being kind of almost like a scary choice while shooting, because the decision to, you know, have minimal coverage it's a big decision. I mean, you can't come back from that. If you don't have the shot, you don't have the shot.
No, and I think we were very clever about that, and we did get the coverage should it have come up. There was always, you know, escape plans if necessary. But all in all, you know, we committed to something and pretty much stayed true to it.